Hello friends, welcome back to Clarity. So friends, moving further, we will be discussing one more important report, that is Emission Gap Report, and this report is published by Unep in 2019. Just few months back, around October number, this report was published. What you know that Unep is United Nations Year Environment Program. Okay, and the headquarter of this is in your way, Nairobi, Kenya. So let's move forward and discuss about what UNEP says about this Emission Gap Report, that is EGR. So as I said it earlier, that this report is published by your UNEP, which has its headquarter in Nairobi, Kenya. So what when we study about this report is EGR, the report is your EGR. The most important term in this report is your this gap. What is this gap about? Okay, so let's understand about this gap. So what this report says is that in the coming years, the mean temperature of Earth is going to increase. Okay, mean temperature of Earth now is it's around, you can say, 0.84 degrees Celsius. It is going to increase, and UNEP has taken some baseline for this temperature, say pre-industrial level. Okay, in pre-industrial level, the timeline is your 1850. Around that period only industrialization took place. Okay, so this is the time period. Around this is the baseline. The temperature considered is around your, say, 0 degree Celsius, and now it is, say, 0.84 degree Celsius. And as we are emitting greenhouse gases and we are disturbing our environment, so what is happening? The mean temperature of Earth is increasing day by day. So what UNEP says, if we cut the emission of our greenhouse gases, then only we can limit the temperature of Earth to around 1.5 degrees Celsius or 2 degrees Celsius by 2030. So this decade is very important, from 2020 to 2030. Our emission cut should be, if it is 7.6%, then we can reach to 1.5 degrees Celsius. Okay, and if the emission cut is around 2.7%, then we can reach at this level, that is 2 degrees Celsius of pre-industrial level. So this report talks about this gap only, how to fill this gap and how we can cut our greenhouse gas emissions so that we can achieve this target. And the target is what? We should achieve at least 2 degrees Celsius of our Earth, and we should limit it to around 1.5 degrees Celsius. So upper maximum level is your 2 degrees Celsius, and it should be limited to around 1.5 degrees Celsius. If it's more than that, then there will be many catastrophic events in our Earth, and we'll face this situation due to climatic changes. So as per this report, what are all the four important, that is greenhouse emitting, gas emitting countries? The first rank is taken by China. China emits the maximum number of greenhouse gases quantity wise. Then is your USA, European Union, and fourth, our Indian rank is fourth. We are emitting greenhouse gases. Okay, we are in fourth number. So this four countries contributes around 55% of total emissions on this Earth. Okay, and if we talk about G20 nations, all the G20 nations contribute about 78% of all the emissions. So these stats are very important. You must remember, at least you must remember, that these four countries are contributing around 55% of all the emissions. If we talk about what it report says, the maximum greenhouse gases comes from which sector? It comes from your energy sector. This is important. Then use your industry, forestry, transport, agriculture, and building. See, agriculture is not in the foremost runner. It's around 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th rank. Agriculture comes in the 5th segment. First is your energy sector. If you talk about the potential of energy transition, means this report talks how we can minimize this greenhouse gases. So every year this report says certain technologies we should use. So this year, this report focuses on your power sector, transport sector, and building sector, how we can use different technologies to reduce greenhouse gas emissions in this sector, that is power, transport, and building. Emission in 2018, including from land use changes, it is around, see, you should remember this data also, that is 55.3 gigatons of carbon dioxide equivalent. So these are important stats from this Emission Gap Report. You must remember for your upcoming examination, right? So that's it, my dear friend, from this report, that is Emission Gap Report. We have discussed all the important data, stats, and concepts related to this report, which can be asked in your upcoming phase 2 examination. Thank you, my dear friends.